In our video on how to configure this TreeView web part, I demonstrated how we could use something called the attribute parent field to specify which attributes you could pass from this TreeView over to this graphic or any other web part that's on this page. And I configured it so that there was an attribute called MySVG that I could pass from one to the other. And as I click on different nodes, we're passing different SVG file references over here so that we can see different things in the pie graphic. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the mechanism, please go back and look at that video. It's the video on configuring the PI TreeView web part. What I'd like to do now is make changes to this so that instead of specifying the attribute parent as a hard-coded value, see, in other words, instead of specifying this attribute parent here with a hard-coded actual string, instead, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a link to something that we're calling a query string. And that query string allows us to pass the attribute parent as part of the URL. So essentially, what we'll do is we'll be able to create a display that is going to show us different things depending on what we pass as part of the URL. So I can pass a different attribute parent, and then of course, what we show here, or what we're able to pass within here, can be different. Now, this query string functionality is not something that's limited just to this field. If you notice, all of these fields, even the query date, is something that we can define using a query string parameter such that instead of, you know, hard coding a root for this particular tree view, I can instead pass that root as part of the URL. So just to give you an example, with this particular display, I could pass as part of the URL both the root and both the attribute parent so that when a user, you know, links to this from different parts of, or different links that are passing different URLs to get to this page, we could actually see different results depending on what URLs were passed. Now again, if you're unfamiliar with this whole concept of attribute parent, go back and take a look at the video on defining this PI TreeView. That's where we go through this in great detail. But I'm going to go ahead and start by breaking the current solution. See, right now we've got this hard-coded in here. We've hard-coded the name of that tank as the attribute parent. I'll go ahead and break that. And by breaking that, what you'll notice is that the mechanism we saw enforced just a second ago is no longer working. We're no longer passing these. That's because there is no attribute parent defined. I'm going to need an attribute parent. Remember, it's the attribute parent, whatever, you know, whichever AF attribute or AF element we designate as the attribute parent, it's this, its list of attributes that we're going to be able to pass. And this is the one that I'm interested in, this my SVG. So we're passing different SVGs. All I need is a reference to one of these elements here. So I think for this one, I know I already have a reference to this that I can copy and paste just to save on some typing. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to pass that as my attribute parent. So yeah, that's what we're going to do for this exercise. I'm going to be passing this as an argument to the URL. So how would we go about doing that? Well, I've already broken this, so how would we go about fixing this? The first thing we would do is we would go into the attribute parents field and click on the little lightning bolt. That allows us to specify a query string parameter. And the query string parameter it's a common concept in working with web parts. But what we do is we define an arbitrarily named query string, and then we make reference to that query string within the URL. And that's how we specify which particular values are going to which fields here. So I'm going to specify this query string as just something arbitrary, ABC, XYZ, something like that. Now again, let me demonstrate what I did. I'm going into this attribute parents field, and I'm defining the name of the query string that we're going to be using to pass a value into this field right here. And I could do the same thing over here. I could define a query string, you know, I could call it something like root node, and then that would be the name of the query string that will be interpreted to be the value for this field right there. In this case, I'm just going to do one. So I'm going to go here to Attribute Parents. I will call this something completely arbitrary, so there's no doubt in anybody's mind that this is something you get to make up yourself. This is not a reserved word. Now, those of you who've used web parts for a while, you may recognize that at one point in the earlier versions, we were using reserved words for query strings. In this current release, we are making it completely up to you what you name these query string parameters. I'll go ahead and name it that. And having done that, I've really accomplished next to nothing here because I haven't exploited it. How can I exploit this now that I've defined that? Well, I can exploit it by creating a link somewhere on my web page that will take us to this particular page and pass that argument. And the argument is going to be, it takes the format of the URL along with it's going to be the question mark and then the query string name and then the equal sign and then the path to the AF element. Now that's a real mouthful there, so let's just take a look at what I'm talking about here. So this is the steps that you would do in order to set this up. I've already done the first two. I've clicked on this bolt, I've defined my query string ABCXYZ, and the grand finale to this, once we've done all this, is now you have to create a link somewhere. Now, in my example right here, I've just created a link in a links web part. So I just created a generic links web part. I created a link that, this is a very long URL here, so this extends all the way out here. And then at the very end of that, this is where you're going to be putting it's the question mark. After the question mark, we put the name of that query string, followed by the equal sign. And then the very last thing we're going to put is that path. And that path takes the syntax that, it's the same syntax you'll see when you define the AF node, the root node. So in fact, that's a good place to copy it from if you just want to save yourself some typing. So yeah, that's how we're going to do it. This is just a note here, but this shows you what the full thing would look like. Yeah, again, this what we're seeing right there, that's going to be the URL. And this is going to be what we're passing to the URL at the end. It's that question mark, the name of the the name of the query string, the equal symbol, and then the rest of it is going to be the path to the AF element.